Nice.
Or I like that one.
Life. By all means, keep playing with, you know, sound effects, but now you're quiet. Okay.
Hello, people.
Well, hello, people. People we ran off earlier already.
Hello.
Welcome. This is Montblanc's Hunters. And so this is a Final Fantasy role-playing game that is based on the Fantasy Flight's Genesys system, but flavored for Final Fantasy. And so this is a game that's set in Ivalice and is part of Montblanc's Hunt Club. And so the Mega Drive. I laugh at that joke every time.
It never gets old.
It doesn't. Shall we all introduce ourselves before we get rolling? Who wants to say hi? No one.
Golly. I'll start. Start. All right. I am known around Twitch parts as Oso Rojo, if people manage to pronounce it correctly, that is. I am playing Ruxel, who is a Benga monk. I've decided recently that he's probably a Ruga Benga. Is that how you say it?
A what Benga?
A Ruga Benga. Gentle. Monk-like.
Oh,
who I want to
nice.
Take you.
Yeah. Reptilian monk. The strong, quiet type. Exactly the opposite of me.
I have that in my head now. What? Okay, so I'm super upset because I made, Invader Kid has seen this. I made a video for raids.
Yes.
I actually made a video for raid, and it did not play. I am upset. Thresh Putin, thank you for the raid. Thank you for the resub. I really do appreciate that. What is that? If we could all thank you for that, but if we could all give Thresh Putin a Koopa Koopo. My music is playing.
Sorry, I'm
sorry about that.
And I know you hate me, Tango. I'm sorry.
What's really sad is I hadn't hit record on Zencaster yet, so I didn't.
Oh.
That part I missed. So I'm sorry. Mm. Also the Beach Boys joke. I might actually just pull the sound off the stream for those jokes because those were worth it.
Oh wow.
Goodness. Okay, who's up?
Well,
what were we doing?
I'm Vader Kid 08. I'm Vader Kid 08. Welcome in, Raiders. Welcome to Techno Funk Boys channel. I'm a variety streamer. I have had the pleasure to hang out with all these fine young folks here. And my character is Vatur, a dragoon. And I like to jump up in the air and smack stuff with my spear. And I don't know anything about Final Fantasy. Disclaimer: I'm learning. I'm gonna be playing some games about that here soon, so I'm gathering up on the lore. And thank you for having me.
You gonna stream them when you play?
Doesn't work here. Yes.
Nice.
Rave, who are you?
I am Ravenant, amateur woodworker, pen maker, member of the Dyson Dreary podcast. Today I will be playing Horse Nordfink and his massive molars. He is a Sikh fighter.
Oh, goodness. I am Paul the Techno Funk Boy, and I'm going to be your game master tonight. And so a couple of things to hit as we go. The first thing is make sure everybody here to go follow Maps for Martians channel, because we are going to be doing an open mic night tomorrow there. And it's going to be rad. And Vader Kid's playing. I'm going to be playing. And yeah, it's going to be hot. So Maps is in chat. You can follow his name. Make sure you're on that because it's going to be fresh. The two we've done so far have been just a blast. And so, and I've got so many depressing songs that I wrote in like my angsty early 20s. It's going to be hot.
H-A-W-T.
Kazoo solos incoming. Yes. Yeah. So, as we play, if you look at the channel points right below the chat box. Wait, did I set those up?
They're there.
They are there. Okay. okay. So you will be able to either give our players a boost die, which is the blue ones, or a setback die, which are the black ones. And so boost die will help them on their roll. Vader Kid, stop that. Every single time.
That's how you do it.
That's the advantage. Is it just the advantage and disadvantage? It's not the boost die,
yes.
Is it? Okay, let me fix that. I can fix that real quick. Give me just a sec.
I can fix it.
It's not gonna be bad. Even Thresh Feud. So hold off just a second, because those are the wrong dice. So you'll be able to help or harm the players when you do that, which will be really, really fun. And let me,
I think that counts. That should count.
Nope. I've declared it.
Techno, this is freaking me out. I just noticed your Discord and the stream videos are facing two different directions.
Oh, what? Yeah. Well, is I think it? they're mirrored, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, which is...
It's just funky.
It's right and neat.
I don't know what to do with that. It's normal for me. That's weird.
Oh, when I'm on Zoom, I flip it because it's like looking into a mirror, you know, so your face doesn't look so weird to yourself. Is that?
Maybe I did that. Because I was just going to. Sorry about that, people. I should have done that earlier, and I obviously did not.
Does it make you feel bad that the flip part is the part that people see, and the mirror part is the part that you see? People see the undesirable version of yourself.
we don't have to be in character, yeah, right? So I can just say like my head's sort of shaped like a kidney bean. You know, and when I see it flipped, it I look like a mutant to myself. It's really shocking. It's like hearing your own voice, but the face version of it. You know, it's hard.
I'm just having like an existential crisis here. I don't know which is the right Paul.
Yeah, and Ray, if your sprite's all backwards. It's just tripping me out, man. Shouldn't it be looking to the right?
No, I think that's always been looking to left.
No, in Dungeons,
just that way too seriously.
Look, no, in Dungeons and Dragons, you always go left. That is very important. Mm. Okay.
So, is your CRT behind your left shoulder or your right?
Left shoulder. This is my left hand.
Yeah, that's right. That's right.
That's No, left.
Oh, no, but yeah, that is correct.
All right.
But I was looking in Discord. Anyway, okay.
So, this is going swimmingly, swimmingly so far.
Swimmingly.
Oh, goodness. Y'all have been called in.
We're going to roll Destiny.
Destiny. Good, good, good point.
Do I get inspiration for that?
Hater Kid, thank you for the gift sub to Osorojo. Really appreciate it. Thank you.
Tell me you're up to...
And Osorojo, pay it forward to Shop Girl. Thank you so much. okay, so let's go ahead and all the players roll me... Somebody already did. Roll me one... white die and we'll get the destiny pool go.
Oh, whoops, I didn't do it right because I didn't have a white die. I have to click one on white and then hit roll destiny.
You can hit the roll destiny button. Uh-oh. Too. It works. Oh, Dave, okay, thank okay. you for the
choo,
bit.
Choo choo choo.
Very nice. So
look at this, y'all.
Did everybody roll?
I don't think I rolled it right. Was it one white and then you have to hit destiny?
Or you can do special rolls and roll destiny.
Roll. I think horse does to roll too.
It is your okay. destiny.
No, we got everybody.
I rolled it. Yeah.
Yep. All right. We're we are all on board. So we got two light side and one dark side. So you are in your home base of Rabanester. And normal day, it's sunshiny, kind of a dry area here. And you are probably heading in to the Hunt Club to see if we have any postings available. I'm assuming you're heading in. But
yes.
You are greeted. You do go up to the board and you do see a new posting, and it looks interesting. It says that there is Babs. Thank you so much for the bits. I really appreciate it. It says needed help exterminating a rat.
I was going to make a rats in the basement joke, too.
Despite all your rage?
Exactly. Yes.
It's not how the song goes.
This is wrong.
Just rat in the basement.
Once we... Vader Kid needs to pay for that. Needs to pay for that with a setback later. We'll get to that. It says, you know, willing to pay adventurers to remove rat from house. Babs, holy smokes. Thank you so much. The hype train is going. We have reached level one. Woo! Awesome. It's gonna take so long. It's a good thing I haven't prepared a lot.
I don't have a choo-choo sound effect. I'm looking for one.
Chupo chupo.
Chupo chupo.
We're never even going to get this thing off the ground, are we?
So you do notice that Montblanc himself has seen you taking a look at this, and he kind of comes over, and he is a very well dressed Moogle, has a little tuft of yellow of like a blonde hair on top of his head, and he comes over. He's like, Kupo, see, you saw the new posting.
So, indeed, rats, huh? We have.
For the amount that they're offering, I doubt that it's going to be a simple rat, but might be worth checking out.
I think we're up to the challenge. I tap my spear on the ground.
Well, here,
hit my chest a little bit.
Let me give you something. And he comes over. He goes over to the side. He gets like this bag, and he kind of holds it up to you, with his tiny little Moogle arms.
Moogly.
I do hate it when you call me that.
Moogly, Moogly.
I'll take the bag.
Okay.
I'll take the bag. I reach out with an iron claw. Loop it. Open it up. And I guess we should all gather around and take a peek inside. And DM can tell us what's in there, huh?
You find...
Does a golden light come out?
What's that?
Is there a golden light coming out?
Golden light comes out, yes. You find 6... mallets, and you know these to be luck mallets that will turn you back from being tiny. And he goes, I have a feeling about this one.
I'm gonna look back at him. I'm a man of few words, a reptile of few words. I'll say, is this it?
That's it.
These hammers are kind of small. I prefer this one.
6 mallets.
So how big are they?
The mallets?
Yeah.
I don't know. Like that? I mean,
like that
yeah.
big?
Yeah.
I pick one up with my hands and I just hold up like this. I'm like, this is supposed to help us how?
Well, it might not. Might. Who knows? Good luck.
Lore check. What happens if you mallet an already diminutive Moogle? just asking.
Well, that's the Moogle's normal size, and so he would turn tiny.
Very tiny.
Very tiny.
Would he be helpful if we brought him along in our pocket on this adventure?
It'd be like the what Moogle was that in Final Fantasy IX that stays in tiny form with Iko the whole time.
Jesse.
All right, so you'll have the address if you all want to go check it out. If not, then we will end the stream here.
Oh, good night, y'all. It was fun.
Peace.
I'll reach out a claw into that bulletin board. I assume there's some phone numbers hanging down on the bottom of the,
right,
of
yeah,
the thing
yeah.
that's been posted.
It has addresses just... with little cuts on it. And you just
yeah. So I'll swipe one of those guys. We'll follow up on it.
All right. So yeah, this is a pretty the neighborhood. It's a pretty wealthy neighborhood in Upper Rabanester. Kind of all the wealthy people live in, and so you head in that direction and you get into the neighborhood and you find yourself in front of a pretty large large house. Kind of all the houses are kind of situated close together here because it's still kind of a crowded city, but this is a big nice two-story house, kind of classic architecture. Even most of the town is pretty like brownish, but it seems to have a nice coat of white paint on it. And you have arrived. If y'all want to go check it out, then you will be invited inside. Anything
yes.
you want to do first?
So I'm going to scan the perimeter.
All right.
You know, we also have not gone shopping yet.
Oh, yeah, I'm sorry. If you want to go shopping, you can.
Yeah, I'm mindful of wanting ether. You know, this new economy that's been introduced or whatever, now when I kick it, really drains a dude. You know what I mean? But I mean, will we have an opportunity after popping in here, you think? Or should we go gear up first? We know we've got a rat on our hands.
Yeah, I apologize. We could totally rewind. And I haven't actually updated your weapons, but it is your weapons are the damage is 1 point higher than what it actually says on the character sheets. Because I got carried away with abilities and stuff, and I forgot to actually update your character sheets.
Okie doke. Yes, I'd love to go to the market. Going to just kind of nudge us down the street a little bit before we go knock on the door. Gentlemen, how do you feel?
Yeah,
I'm standing behind you.
All right,
lead the way.
Okay, so yeah, there is a kind of a club centurio vendor in the bazaar that y'all are well acquainted with, and so he has most of the things that you would want. Ethers are 200 gil a piece.
Okay, I would like. Was there a dollar amount on the posting? I mean,
no, not yet.
Oh, but Montblanc said for the amount they're offering, he should have known. We should have shaken him down for more information before we went spending. But I think I was advised not to use the Moogle mallet on him. So, you know, I'm going to get 2 ether. I could always use it later, I'm sure.
Cool.
Ether, is that those for a magic point?
Yeah, well, but his abilities. Abilities now use strain.
Aha.
So that'll get me. Let's see, 12 more kicks. In addition.
Yeah.
Wait, I'm doing my math weird. Whatever. It gives me more kicking.
More
kicking. That's like a whole group of showgirls. Yes.
All right. Anybody else looking for something?
I probably need to buy an ether as well.
Okay.
Is there a need for the ability to buy like torches or some sort of light source if we're going to be in the basements?
It's not needed.
Okay.
I think Final Fantasy kind of assumes you have that because I don't remember a single game that torches were a thing.
Okay. Maybe I've been watching too much Dragon Warrior lately.
Yeah.
Bonk, 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 bonk. And I'm just wondering, okay, so we're going to be down in basements and stuff like that. Would I know to expect running into, undead or any particular class of monster?
You would not expect so in the city.
Not in the city.
Yeah.
All right.
I mean, yeah, this is, this is like the wealthy neighborhood of a walled city. And it's extremely rare for any sort of monster to get in here.
Okay. And we still have fire materia, right? What did we use the last time? Does it even matter?
You still have it.
Okay.
I like that. I like that hype train emote.
That's a cool doggo.
Yeah, what is it? Oh, he's licking his own nose. That's quite the talent. That's
not okay. Where I thought you were going with that.
There we go. There's a million of them. I'm good. Does anybody else want to buy anything else?
Just that one ether. I think I'm good.
I think I'm all set. At some point, can we upgrade our materials?
Yeah. Probably not.
Okay, thanks. Well, moving on.
Okay. Do you mean at some point in this adventure or just at some point in our lives?
In this adventure, no.
Okay.
Once the rules committee gets around to it.
Exactly. I only can do one thing at a time, and it's normally not the thing you'll ask for.
Fair. All right. Well, I'm good. I'll gesture wordlessly back to. When you said that, I was imagining like row houses in San Francisco. You know, like the opening sequence of Full House or something.
Yeah, pretty much like that.
Okay, so I'll go gesture that way.
All right, great. So all the things I said preemptively still apply. you've reached the house slightly later than you would have otherwise, and make your way to the door. You see kind of a large, well-dressed man, very polite, answer the door, and says, "Yes, may I help you?"
Did you say he is a well-dressed man?
Yes.
A sharp-dressed man?
Just really reaching for references today.
something about it.
I say to him, "Good day, sir. We saw this posting and it has brought us here. Me and my companions are interested in the work that you..."
ZZ Tupo.
ZZ Tupo. Yes.
Wow.
That one's on you.
Wow. This is getting out of control.
Thresh Pugh's trying to get me back for a pun I made earlier. It's on his channel. Yes, very good. Come, we will. Miss Pennywhistle will be very anxious to speak with you. Come this way. He kind of bows and lets you in,
and we proceed in. Or at least I proceed in.
Okay,
I can't speak for my counterparts.
Oh, I'm a follow.
Yeah,
I'm a follow.
So it's pretty decent sized entry, with kind of tile floors and, you know, not a lot that's actually going to absorb sound. And so you hear that kind of echoing as you go. And he will turn into a library of sorts. You see the fire going in the fireplace, and it's a very, very old woman, very, very pale, is sitting there, and she has a calico cat on her lap that she's petting, and she goes, "Jotham, was there someone at the door?" And he goes, yes, Miss Pennywhistle, these men are here about the rat problem." And she says, "Oh, come in, my eyes are not what they used to be."
All right, we'll come in. Yeah. I spy a decanter of something over in the corner. I'm gonna walk over to it. Just kind of give her a look, like a may I type of look.
Yeah, and she can't see that far, so she doesn't even notice. And so you're fine.
I'm just gonna grab some. All right, I'm ready. I'm gonna knock the edge off before the adventure. But I'll sidle up closer to her so we can. Yeah. Converse.
Interesting crew, are you? You think the spear is necessary?
I take it with me everywhere I go. Oh. It's a part of me.
Oh, wow.
And he means everywhere.
Indeed, my friend speaks correctly.
like no one stands beside you at the urinal.
Never.
They always
get a little awkward.
You always go to the far left or the far right, never in the middle. No one understands this.
Right, thank
My
you.
My spear takes so
Okay, I gotta tell you all this. This is a true story. I was at my job, I wasn't a manager, but we were hiring like a ton of people, and so they had a lot of like the high performing people like do some of the interviewing. And I was on that interview team, and my very real suggestion to my boss was, look, whenever we have a guy come in for an interview, like, look, you know what's going to, you know what happens at a job interview. First thing you do, he's got that nervous pee going. So you go to the, you go to the restroom. And I think that, like, you station some people in there to just kind of observe. And if he goes to that middle urinal, he's out. Just unqualified.
Immediately.
You do a quick interview just to make sure, you know, just to, like, you know, just for appearance's sake, but out of contention.
Poor guy comes out. Comes out of the restroom. Sorry, sir. Decision has been made. We apologize for not being able to.
Like the guy washing his hands turns around and like, no, you're out. I'm sorry. You're
failed the first
you are
test.
A middle urinal pisser. You get out of here.
Go home.
All right.
The spear is necessary.
Yes. So Miss Pennywhistle will say, oh, that's some interviews with Ed Amazon. If they ask where the restroom is, I'm sorry, you're not qualified. she said, well, yes, we have a rat that's been quite driving us crazy. Isn't that right, Jotham? And the man goes, quite. And she goes, well, yes, it's causing us all sorts of troubles because Mr. Fluffy Bum here has tried to catch it, but to no avail. It's quite a nuisance. We had some, you know, pest control out here, and they said that it wasn't a rat, and there was nothing they could do about it. And I begged to differ, but they just left anyway. So I am willing to pay you 2,700 gil to rid us of this rat.
Oh.
We accept the quest, madam. And I bow.
Oh, do we?
And then I look over at you. If there's a, like, 2,700 gil is a lot of money. Yeah.
I mean, I'm thinking to myself, there's real good money in penny whistles, apparently. We know it's not a rat, right, guys? But it's 2,700 gil. Let's go for it.
If I can hit it, I don't care.
That's, yeah, that's straight indeed. Up.
That is very good. I do appreciate it. You can have the run of the house however you wish, and let's see. When was the last time we saw it, Jonathan? And the man says, "It was last night, miss." And she goes, "Yes, yes, yes. It turned the ham into ice." Anyways, good luck.
I'd like to point to Mr. Fluffy Bottom. Was that a Fluffy Bum?
Fluffy Bum. Mr. Fluffy Bum, yes.
Mr. Fluffy Bum. Fluffy Bum. Say, the cat. He comes with us.
What?
You think you're going to get hungry later?
No. He's a mouser. He's a mouser. Come on. He's a cat. I just think he'd be an asset, you know?
And
before, she's not going to give him up, but I'm going to try.
And,
you know?
And before Miss Penny Whistle can say a word, Mr. Fluffy Bum, like, licks his lips, jumps up, and comes and rubs against your leg and purrs.
Yeah. All right.
Well, I guess right. That's decided then. Very good.
Oh man, I'll take this plot twist all day long.
Hey, Power.
I lean. What's up? I lean into Ruxel, and I say, "Are you sure this is a good idea? That woman seems awfully attached to her cat."
That is a good I don't want to lose any of this $2,700.
The cat looks up and goes,
I roll my eyes as best a reptile can.
Bader kid, did you prep that sound effect? I bet not. Yeah.
Got a kitty sound there?
Hang on.
Sounded just like that.
Nailed it.
Nailed it.
That was uncanny.
There we go.
It's exactly the sound I made.
Well, anyway, I'm gonna shoot Mr. Fluffy Bum away with my leg.
We are 30 minutes in. We already have a snort laugh. I am happy.
Okie doke. Well, I'm gonna cast about for something else to bring with me. I don't know, since Mimosa's not here, I feel like asking for more from the people we interact with is, you know, somebody's got to carry that torch, right?
Oh yeah, yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
I nudge you again. The decanter.
You nudge the decanter. Yeah, yeah. But she can't even see that. I'm just gonna go grab the decanter.
No, we got a setback dice.
Okay.
I mean, I'll turn around and look. It's too late for permission.
Thrashputin meant to do a boost and put a setback, but you already have a boost.
That's right.
And now, y'all gotta chill. We don't do that many rolls early in the game. Save your points. We're gonna need them.
Am I gonna need to roll for petty theft?
No. Okay. Jonathan sees and he doesn't seem to care, and he says, "Gentlemen, right this way."
Mm. And, all right,
we'll take you into the dining room, and says, and the cat's following. Jim's friend, will say, "This is in this room is where we normally see the creature. It's not a rat. I don't know what it is, but I think you've probably picked up on that if you're any good, as you claim to be. But it is normally in here that we will catch a glimpse of the monster."
What's it look like?
Oh, about way high, red hair, clean shaven. Wears kind of like a green tunic.
That's a leprechaun. It's a leprechaon.
I don't think it's.
Does he have gold buckles?
No, he's.
Has he said anything about Lucky Charms?
Delicious marshmallow cereal mixed in with cat food.
I think the blue pants suggest that perhaps he's. Not a leprechaun.
Oh. Mm. Oh, one of those silent moments again. Here's the deal. Mm. None of the three of us are talkers. Can we just
appoint him? How often does it show up?
Well, pretty much daily. We will normally catch him when we've put food on the table.
She mentioned a ham.
Yes.
Do you have a ham?
Well, we have perhaps some leftovers from yesterday. It's been
bring out the ham.
It's been on ice since then, you know. Ed.
What part of the house are we in?
You're in the dining room.
The dining room.
I do this. I stretch my chin. Is there a basement?
A basement? No. Did you want there to be?
No, my concern is that if we have to take this thing out, I don't want to rough up your kitchen.
Well, I'm hoping that it won't be too rough. It's quite small.
You're saying that it turned the ham into ice. Is that right?
Yes.
Doesn't sound like a rat to me.
Well, I think we've established that. Do you normally have someone in your party who does the talking for you?
Small one. Can't remember her name. Right. Sounds like a martini, I think.
Big ears. Big ears.
Martini, screwdriver, big ears.
And yeah, right on cue. Thank you so much, Jim, for the sub.
There we go. 18 months. A year and a half of this?
A year and a half.
I don't even know. Oh. A year and a half of this.
Amazing.
Well, yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and take a scaly mitt and slap Vatur in the back of the head. Say food. Bring out some food.
Food, good.
Very good, sir. I'll be happy to bring some. And Jonathan will come and take go into the kitchen and come back with all sorts of meats and cheeses and assorted fruit and breakfast cereals and orangutans and all sorts of good food.
Thanks.
Jin can do the dialogue from chat.
Excellent.
I did catch what you were doing there, but I had no witticism to go along with it.
We just want to kill things. That's what we're here for.
I figured my horse Nordfink was good enough.
Right.
But I think we now sit and wait for a little bit.
Okay. Now we play the waiting game.
Yeah, so
I pull out a penny whistle and play a little Irish ditty. A song of my people.
Goodness. All right, so let's do some rolling.
Oh.
Rolling.
What do you want us to roll?
It's going to be perception.
Mm-hmm. Great.
And now purple. You do have it's four purple.
Aww.
And so, okay, y'all have been loaded up on dice. And so the first person who rolls gets a boost die. And the second person gets a setback. And then we have three boosts after that.
I've only got two perception, so I'll take the setback. Because
I only have one gold perception.
I have one gold, two greens.
All right, you go first. You get the boost,
dude. You receive a great deal.
All right. Roll.
Rolling. Snap, dog.
Oh, dang.
I think you just perceived the entire universe.
Wait. Like, I think I accidentally rolled a white.
You could.
Oh, you did. To do that. Oh, you didn't do.
But you
any.
Just rolled the dark side point.
Well, he didn't do any purple.
All right, yeah. Take it back.
Okay, you need four purple and one black.
Four purple and one black.
Stop the white die.
Four purple, one black. Okay.
Right, with your perception. Here we go.
And then I roll my perception, one yellow, two greens.
Jim Spence says, does this game normally use this dice set, or are you using it because you like it? Well, we're inventing this game as we go, so yes, we're using it because we like it. Oh,
one success.
Atur does. I with all the successes earlier, I was going to say that you had tried the brownies and they were special, and you were perceiving all sorts of stuff. But with only one success, you did not have the brownies.
I perceive, man.
Y'all go ahead. Everybody, go ahead and roll it. I gave you the black instead of the blue. Anyways, it worked out. So y'all, the other ones can use blue.
Well, I'm a dumbass. I just noticed I was like in the wrong channel anyway, but I fixed it.
So I have a threat.
I have two failures and a threat.
Dumb. Yeah,
okay. All right. Oh, so Vatur.
You got a boost, Ruxel.
Oh, wait, what? I was supposed to add a boost?
Yes.
Yeah, I took the
The setback. Vatur accidentally took the setback because I told him to, and I didn't mean it, but he succeeded anyway. So, horse,
should I reroll?
Don't go. Horse definitely shouldn't, because you're not going to overcome.
Do you want me to reroll?
If you want to roll a blue and see if you, well, it's not going to matter.
Just roll the blue. Oh no, nah, let's. Really? It's not going to matter?
You could get a success on it. So go ahead.
You could.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, you did it. So.
I did it.
Yay.
Good job.
All right. So the two of you, Horst is kind of looking the other way. Probably has got a turkey leg just gnawing on that thing. And but the other two of you notice like a little movement from behind like the china cabinet, and out just scurries this what looks like a Hume, but very, very small, and with like this with kind of dark red hair, and
I'm so pumped right now. I'm so pumped right now. Okay. Yeah. Keep on going. Sorry.
And
I'm just excited.
And he kind of runs out and he's heading for the table. And then he sees the two of you. And so he kind of does like the cartoon slide stop or and looks and encounters y'all. So are you going to attack it or are you going to try to talk?
Do I recognize what this thing is?
What would that be? That would be some sort of just do a knowledge roll. Knowledge. This is going to be against three purples.
Okay, so I don't have knowledge. Is it something different?
You do. It's on the right column at the very bottom.
Oh, I see. Okay.
Don't even ask this guy to do like basic addition. It's just not gonna work.
And put a boost on that from chat. So thank you, chat.
Okay. Is that a black?
No, it's a blue.
Oh, okay. One blue. Black? Come on, man.
No. And then was it
how many
purples?
Times have you played this? Three purples.
I'll get the hang of it. Three purple.
In his defense, it's been a while.
Yes.
It has been.
All right. You don't have the foggiest clue.
This is what I would like to do.
You rolled a couple of threats and
I know exactly what it is, but I didn't see it.
I don't know.
Horst has played Final Fantasy IV.
So I've been meditating in the corner, as is my wont as a monk, so I'm hyper aware. I see this thing happening. I would like to roll deftly out of my lotus stance and try to trap this thing, like my kids trap a frog in my backyard. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
Yeah. Just okay. catch it in my reptilian hands.
All right. So let's with that, let's go ahead and roll initiative.
Oh, I thought I was gonna roll athletics or coordination or something I'm actually good at, man. Okay.
Well, roll initiative to see if you get to go first, because he does see you as you see him. And so
how do I roll initiative?
it's gonna be your cool roll.
Oh, okay. Against?
Against nothing.
Okay.
Oh, cool.
Success. Don't make it bad.
Bam.
All right.
Advantage.
Wow. Do I get to trap it in my hands? Like it's a frog? Or a lizard? Some sort of skink?
So I'm pretty cool, but Ruxel's getting the band back together.
Yeah, all right. I'll be Ringo.
It's going to go first, and then the three of you are going to go.
I'm sorry. Are we in an encounter right now?
Yes.
Because this was supposed to be like a like a sneak attack from behind.
Well, you can't sneak attack him. He saw you.
I rolled out of the lotus pose, man. Lotus.
That is surprising, but he did see you.
I just want to catch it. I don't want to fight it. It's so tiny. But okay, what are we supposed to do? We're fighting now, right?
Yeah. All right. So it is. It's going to kind of point at Vatour.
Mm-hmm. Boom! Jump, boy, jump! Come on.
Yeah, unfortunately for Vatour, these ceilings are not that big. Or not that tall.
That's why I was asking about a basement.
You can crash. Thank you. You can crash through the ceiling into, you know, the tastefully decorated mid-century bathroom upstairs. Pink tile, matching pink toilet. It'll be.
You want a shower in your dining room?
Ooh, yeah.
Who doesn't?
All right. It is it is going to cast the Fira spell at you,
and oh heck,
it is going to hit you for 7 wounds.
What?
Wait, I'm assuming we healed from last time, right?
Oh yeah, yeah.
Okay, because my stuff wasn't updated, so. So
holy crap.
Oh no, I don't want to delete this character. All right, that's good. I hit the minus sign. I was like, whoa, that would have been bad.
All right, so it starts to scurry back the way it came. But y'all do have an opportunity first. So y'all could go with the three of you. It's your turn now. So in any order that you want.
Okay.
So what was the spell that I got hit with? What does it do?
Fira.
Yeah, it's fire, it's fire. 2. Yeah, fire 2.
Yeah. It's,
oh, fire 2.
Yeah, that is an advanced spell, my dude. You're crispy. Wait. Yeah.
So you like you got like just hit with this pillar of fire, and
yeah, like you had a fountain firework on the 4th of July that you thought was a dud, and then you knelt
Roman candle
to check. Yeah. And then it blew up in your face.
Maps is in chat trying to talk to Vader. Vader Kid is busy right now. This is why he couldn't tell what spell hit him.
I don't know. I don't know what it was. Forget Maps, I'm Final Fantasy illiterate.
Oh, wait, what hit me?
I would like to run up and hit it with a hammer.
Wait, a Moogle hammer?
No, my hammer.
Oh, okay. Your Warhammer. Your Warhammer 40K, if you will.
Copyright.
Yeah.
Oh, now he's going to get a strike on his channel.
Sorry, Techno Funk Boy.
All right.
Techno Canceled Boy. Still have an advantage queued up.
Yes, you do.
Okay. And what am I rolling against?
2 purple. Oh, dang.
That would be 5 success, 4 advantage.
Okay.
Dag.
What is your base damage?
6.
Do 5 now, because you said it went up 1.
Yeah. Slow.
Wow, nice. I was trying to tell a joke, but
it's close. Yeah. All right. What do you want your advantage to be?
No more Fira.
you knocked the Fira right out of his head.
Stunlock.
Oh, I didn't use my fire materia either.
You knock him back in. It. Wait, do you have a mute mallet? Is that what your hammer is?
Oh, it should be.
Yeah, I just made that up, but it's a thing now.
I get like a stun or something.
Oh, I like that we're in the dining room, right? There's an ornate chandelier up above us, and I like that it falls off of the ceiling because of the crash of the hammer, and that little dude gets all tangled up in it.
I dig it. In fact, I don't even hit him. I hit the chandelier.
You hit the chandelier on the way down to striking him. You crush both.
Yeah.
There's just mayhem
you're
everywhere.
Like, you're like jumping over the table going, brah! knock the chandelier. Yeah, I'm down with it. So like, yeah, that chandelier comes down like right on top of him. And he, you know, he's has to stop his scurrying away right after he got hit by that hammer. And so he is pinned at the moment. Vader Kitted. Enabled emote only mode. Nice. Let's let those emotes fly.
Oh, I can't even say that's whack, dude. Okay. Okay. Let me do an emote here real quick.
Away.
Yeah.
Did Did he hit him? Did he hit the little guy?
Oh yeah, he hit him for big time, man.
Oh.
Oh yeah. Quit trying to help maps and pay attention to the game.
Okay. Well, it's my turn. Do we have any other things queued up, like bonuses or whatever?
You have one more boost. Yeah.
One more boost. Okay. Because I'm just letting you all know now, I have 3,200 channel points to redeem.
Oh.
And I'm not above handicapping for this, but I want to. I guess I need to attack.
Jen is laying down a setback for the next roll. This is your team. Oh. They are carrying the weight for you. but this one has a boost. Sorry, go ahead. What were you to do?
I'm gonna attack like there's no tomorrow. I get 2 gold, 2 green against 2 purple, and I get a boost. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. I have to check with you on something. I've got an iron claw right now, but I think I got a doper claw from a previous adventure. Do you have any recollection of that?
Yeah, we haven't changed it, but your attack is one more. Your damage is one more than it says on the sheet.
Okay. Well, my damage is 4. That's a success and 2 advantages.
Nice. Okay. So what's your base damage? You just said 4. That. You said 4. And that's with the plus 1?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. All right. All right. So you have, you managed to it's actually really impressive because like the chandelier is coming down and you manage to just pop it in the jaw right as the chandelier like crashes down. And so he like flies back, but then he hits the back of the chandelier.
Nice. I would like. Nice.
Oh,
thank
I like
you, Vader kid.
I like that, that variation of the chocobo with the sunglasses on. That's nice. That's cool. Sorry. Go ahead.
For my advantage, as the chandelier lands, this just completely dope, like, cascade of broken glass, like, flies all around. It's, like, in the background, the light shining off of it just right. I snap a dope selfie, and then also a bunch of the glass goes into his eyes, and he can't cast any more magic. Yeah?
I like the first part. That's like, it's a very kind of anime shot of, you posing with the background, going wild.
I'm gonna be real though. I'm not gonna spend an advantage on that. Perhaps a triumph if I can, like cut it in half. But if I'm gonna get an advantage, it's gonna be a battle advantage.
Just remember that broken glass is not a food.
It's not. Thank you, Annie Lennox, for establishing that long ago.
Oh, I was going for the victorious reference. I have kids.
Oh, okay. I do, but I don't get that reference. What am I missing?
I was so happy Maps tried to do the fart command.
Oh.
I can make that happen. I think. No,
don't overdo it. You'll have to change your britches.
Yeah, don't never trust a fart. Never.
Never.
And don't force them.
All right. Advantage. Oh, go ahead.
Oh, you know what? But Vautour, you're a Pop Tart over in the corner, my dude.
I am. I'm trying to get the heat off me.
Is there like, you know what? There's a.
Wait, do you heat up your Pop Tarts? I totally eat those raw. Sorry, go ahead.
Well, you can do it either way. You're a toaster strudel, man. You're a toaster. Nice.
Gooey on the inside.
Yeah, a Totino's pizza roll. So like, what I'd like in all of the mayhem is for a salve on a shelf, on like a hutch somewhere, to be vibrated off of the shelf and just fall right onto Vatur, crack open, and heal some of that fire damage. Right?
Is there only that ham left from yesterday?
Wait, what's on the shelf that's falling on him?
It's like a, you know, it's like a perfume bottle, only it's full of heal, like a healing potion or something from a recent Goop Lab episode, whatever, it doesn't matter. It falls and cracks and heals some of his burn damage.
I like it.
I want to get this guy on his feet.
How much are you thinking?
I mean, it is.
I will.
How much do I think?
I'll go 3.
I don't think a dude's been walloped this hard the entire time we've been doing this together.
That's the biggest hit I've gotten.
Yeah, how many wounds do you have?
My total health is 13.
Yeah, okay. So you got dropped down to like 6?
I have 6, yeah.
6. Okay. I'd take 3 for that. I mean, that way you can at least suffer one more Fira spell and not just be swooned.
Kill over. Okay. Okay. So does that put me at 9?
So for 3 extra wounds?
Yes.
Cool. I'll do it.
Okay. There we go.
That's the sound of that jar sliding off. Okay. All right. Who hasn't actually gone? Vatur has not gone.
I think Vatur, yeah.
I have not.
Okay, go ahead.
So the flame kind of is distinguished by this liquid, and pop off a little bit. And I grab my spear. I'm gonna run in for an attack because I can't jump. And I'm gonna do just a regular melee heavy attack. All right. You said I have one more damage now, right?
Yeah, that's right.
Okay, so that is going to be 1 yellow and 2 greens. Am I rolling against anything or for anything?
You have a setback, so 1 black.
1 black. All right, here we go.
Oh, that's so good, man. Holy moly, you crushed that.
What is your base? What is your base attack?
My base attack is... Well, now it's 5. It says in my character sheet 4.
Okay. Awesome. All right.
I don't
so...
mean to be that guy, but there was no purple in that.
What is wrong with you?
Oh. What?
Roll 2 purple.
Roll 2 purple?
One day you'll get the hang of this, and one day I'll actually check your rolls. Thank you. Thank you, Horst.
Well, it doesn't matter. It can't possibly. That's not possible.
Just roll 2 purple. That's it.
Yeah, 2 purple.
Purple?
Yeah.
2, okay. Oh, just roll 2 purple by itself.
Right.
Right.
Yeah. Solo.
Okay. Oh, it's still hit, but you do have a disadvantage. Yeah. All right.
Okay.
You hit, but there is a disadvantage. I think that as you stick your spear in through this this chandelier, as you stab him and pull it back out, it jostles it a little bit. And perhaps gives him an opening if he can be quick enough. Nice.
If he can be quick enough.
So he is pretty good and pissed at this point.
Yes.
And so he raises his hands up and casts Quake.
No.
No. Oh, good.
I don't like that.
No, you're not going to. All right.
I'm assuming that's like an earthquake.
Yeah. So the whole room just like starts to shake, and everything is like falling down. The china cabinet's falling over. The table is rocking, and food is falling off. And Vatur.
Any little matter manner is not
Batur, you're going to take 5 damage and you fall down.
Ow.
Glad I healed
Horst.
You.
I'm so glad. That would have been dangerous.
Horst, 5 damage, but you stay on your feet.
Ruxel's going to stay on his feet. He's a monk, for Pete's sake. Come on. Have you seen my athletic score lately? It's so good. So good.
Ruxel, 4 damage, and you fall down.
Oh, come on.
And then I am going to flip. I'm going to flip a point to upgrade his escape to see if he can slip through and get out. And he does make it. He slips. He slips by, and scurries back behind the now fallen china cabinet and disappears from sight.
So I went back there. I've known this for quite some time. I procure the bag of mallets. I gesture at them. I grunt. I gesture at the little crack in the wall that he's disappeared through. However, and I hold up a reptilian finger and say, however, this much magic is a lot to deal with.
By the way, from the other room, you hear somebody go, oh dear.
Yeah, I was wondering how Pennywhistle Manor was just feeling in general after the whole thing got shook. I mean, we don't have any wall spells. We don't have any barrier spells. We're just a bunch of meatheads.
We like to hit things.
Yeah, that's true. That is true. Very true.
Hitting things is fun.
How much does a potion recover, DM?
Yeah, let me take a look.
Yeah, I'm going to have to do that too.
5.
That's it.
Got one potion.
How many have you
I've
lost?
Got two.
Or 2.
Well, listen, out of character, meta. You're turning up the heat, and I appreciate it. Now I'm a little scared. That's all I'm saying. So I'm just trying to make sure we got our bases covered,
do
right?
Do you really think I'm going to let you die?
Yeah, I don't know, man.
You'll have some Phoenix Downs, don't you?
Oh, man. I don't have any. Do either of you two have Phoenix Downs?
I think you had at least one.
No.
Brutal. I don't have any. Does Mimosa have our Phoenix down?
Let me check.
I think she does.
That'd be
actually
hilarious.
I'm pretty sure she does.
Let me see what she has, because I won't leave you high and dry if she does. She does not have it on her
shoes. Well, wait. This thing isn't going everywhere. It's been freezing ham for nigh a week. Can't we just bail to the market?
Sure.
Collect ourselves, come back in, and Moogle mallet our way into the...
You do have 2.
Yeah, we just have to hit him more.
Oh, okay. You know what? She redeemed a boost.
Yeah,
and,
both, you have a boost from both Jin and Thrashputin, and so...
Heck yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, so... I don't know. Vautour, you've been carrying Mimosa's handbag just for good luck. Maybe you two have a little thing going on. I don't know. You just kind of miss her. And you fumble around in there and find a phoenix down?
No, there wasn't. She didn't even have any potions. I don't know what's wrong with her.
Oh, okay. We need
I
a phoenix
for
down.
Sure we bought some phoenix downs.
Gosh. It feels like it. Because I remember, I know you found one, and I do believe you bought one as well, and I know you've only used one, and so
have we even used one?
Yeah,
but
you did. You
I don't
did
need to argue.
The,
whatever.
Okay. The death spell, from that that ghost. Yes. You did use one. Okay. But I'd say you have one. Because I think that was me not updating it, because I do remember that.
Okay. Okie dokie. All right. What's that butler's name? Josh. Let's just call him Josh. I like calling him Josh, right? Look Josh. At Josh. Is he still in the room?
Josh. The He's butler. Not in the room, but you can call him. I mean, he'll come.
Oh, no. I just wanted to check and make sure he was okay. I'm sure that was pretty traumatic for a dude. All right. I'm going to look inside the bag. I'm going to pull out a mallet. I'm going to look knowingly at the guys around me. They know what's going on, right? Are we ready for this?
Do we need to go that route? Could we just embiggen the hole?
I kind of wanted to embiggen the little leprechaun guy. If I'm being real, I thought he was going to have some massive like evasion boost, but he didn't seem to. So I held off on the idea.
So
it's fine. You wanted us to go into the mouse hole, man.
Moment of honesty. In the rules, there is an evasion bonus, and I forgot to apply it. So good for y'all.
Yeah. Do we want to Moogle the hole and go in big? Is there a disadvantage to being big compared to him?
It's harder to hit him physically.
Also, we just can't move around in there. After we big in the hole, we've got to worry about the framing, plumbing. Yeah.
Right. Yeah, if he's scurried anywhere in the walls, it's going to be tough for you to follow him without tearing down the house.
So the hammers that we have will make us smaller, is that right?
Right.
Come on. Yeah. It's hunting. No, we have six, right? It was just enough to make us small and then make us big again.
Right, exactly. Oh, that was it.
Okay. Just enough. It's all funny, right, I shrunk the kids. Oh, yeah. I'm so pumped for this right now.
This is
a good story. Okay, can we mallet ourselves? Do we need to mallet each other? Do we set it up like in a triangle and I'll do it simultaneously? Is this like a game of Twister? What's going on? Okay. I'm going to mallet myself.
All right. Okay, so you like get this in hand and you just wallop yourself on the head and it like...
Oh, right in the forehead.
I'm doing color commentary here. So you smack yourself and like the mallet just like erupts in glitter and light. That just kind of absorbs you, and as the glitter falls, like everybody else, like they don't see you anymore, and then they look down and they see a very 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 tiny Ruxel. Whether your voice goes super like helium high, that's gonna be a character choice for you.
I hope so.
Hey guys.
All right, guys, let's go kick some butt.
I'm going to pick you up and like pretend like I'm going to eat you.
Dude, I'm a monk. I'm Zen. I'm lotus position right in the palm of your hand. No big deal.
All right.
When I meet my maker, I know I'm good.
Okay. So is everybody else doing the same?
So can I take a potion first? And how much does that heal me again?
I'm 5. Sorry. Yeah.
I didn't pay. 5.
You know what would suck is if you guys just left. You just left, and then I'm tiny.
All your equipment will size with you, and so you would have like little tiny potions that will do the same effect for you, and your weapons are all the same and stuff.
That's all I want to make sure.
Except for your spear, Vautour, that stays very large. That and
stays
now,
very large.
Yeah. Now it's like a redwood tree trunk that you have to lug around.
He goes through the hole in the wall and it just bangs against the wall.
All right, I'm gonna take the hammer and I'm gonna hit myself with it.
Yeah,
I guess that's how it works.
Okay,
so
horse, are you doing this as well?
I'm gonna walk back to the table, grab a leg of some meaty creature, chew on it for a minute, and then I'll shrink myself.
So as you do that, you all hear from the other side of the room.
Yes. Yes.
And the cat. And the cat charges.
No. Okay. I was hoping to use a triumph for an advantage for this appearance later. I'm glad it has happened now. We're friends.
We need to get out of here.
We're friends, right? No. With my tiny voice, I cry out, "Fluffy butt, it's me."
We need to go.
My wife has been watching a lot of Joe Galaxy lately. He's like the cat whisperer dude. He'd know how to handle this.
Okay.
I'm trying to provide cover for you two to run. So, I'm going to hold off Fluffy because I think we have a connection.
Horst has just grabbed food. He has not hit himself yet.
Oh.
And so you all have a turn before the cat will go, so you can decide what to do.
My character is going to beeline it to the hole in the wall.
Hey, you could jump now.
I can. I'm excited about this.
All right, man.
Would that get me to the hole any faster?
If you roll for bad RP, it's let's see, what is that?
It would be to see if you can make it.
I'm kidding, dude. Run.
It would be a good idea. It would be athletics against three purple.
Oh, okay.
Wow. Okay, athletics. How you doing on athletics, bro?
I got a yellow and two greens.
Oh, you're doing.
And you do. And you do have a boost in the hopper, so.
Ooh, okay. A one boost and against two purple.
I accidentally used a light side point. Y'all should have called me on that. I need to be using dark side. So I just changed that. So two purple, one blue, and then whatever your athletics is.
Two purple, one blue, and athletics. Boom.
Oh, wow. That's okay.
Okay. Two threats, three successes.
Yeah. Okay. So you make it there. I have an idea. I have an idea for the threat. As you're diving through like Indiana Jones style with your helm, like coming off and you have to reach back for it. Your big giant spear, bumps against the hole of the wall. And a loose board comes down and partially covers the hole. So everybody else will still be able to get through. It's just going to be a little bit harder.
Can't it just be a threat to him and not to the rest of us? I mean, we're a team, but are we?
Sorry, guys. Didn't mean for that to happen.
Okay. If I were gonna sweet talk my friend, I mean, it did rub up against my leg and meow before. What skill would I be accessing?
They don't have a charm.
Oh. Hey, Rain. And I would, because you petted it earlier, I would give you a boost on that. We do have a boost in the hopper, so you'd actually have two boost for that.
But like my charm's only two. That's still kind of a gamble.
Yeah, well, I mean, look, you know, there's like I have a cat, and lizards try to make friends with it all the time, and it doesn't always work out.
How family friendly is this channel?
Well, without Jen playing, it's more so than not.
My cat ate a toad in front of me the other night.
Ow!
And it immediately rejected the toad. It was the most traumatic thing ever. And I'm having flashbacks of this right now, right? Because here I am, just a reptile, living my life, trying to make 2,300 gil. I don't want that to happen, man. Can I?
Thank you, Vader Kid.
When does the cat go? Dude, we didn't roll for initiative, right?
You're keeping the same initiative. It's going after y'all, after all y'all.
Of course, you and I can't really like have a huddle up right now because I'm tiny and you're big.
Well, I can go before you if you want.
Yeah. So with my tiny little claws and my tiny little voice, I scream, "The cat! The cat!" And or, gesture wildly at the cat.
He's coming for you, Axel.
I can't even understand Vautour with that thing on. I don't know if there's like a you know, not quite that small setting on.
Let me see. I'll keep looking.
You have a turkey leg, dude. There's probably some fish or something up there that you can just throw.
That's exactly what I was
doing. Oh, nice. Okay. Yeah.
I like it.
What do you toss to the cat?
Oh, what do I think cats like?
Thanks for the letter.
Well, what's on the table, man?
A chicken wing.
Yeah, I know a lot about cats. What's on the table?
What do you want to be there? And
well, what you know about cats doesn't matter.
Ruxel doesn't know anything about
this,
cats.
This is actually a good case for like having a light side point to say, you know, yes, there is fish there, and flip a light side to make it there.
Yeah, like a can of albacore tuna. Ooh, yeah.
Mm. Ooh.
A meow mix.
Hey, okay.
Shiba. Yes. Fancy fees.
This is a rich place. It's got to be that canned fancy fee stuff that's served in the crystal bowl.
You know, gotta be.
Is that what you want?
Sure.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah.
He's trying to sucker us into using light side points.
Absolutely. I needed a dark side back. So yeah, yeah. There's like the crystal bowl with the fancy feast in it that he brought out. So you're gonna plop that down in front of the cat.
Yeah.
I'm
totally not gonna just throw it at the cat.
That's what I was gonna ask. Are you just like dump it over in front of him, or chuck the bowl at its head, or just gonna give it to him?
Being horsed, I would just upend it right in front of him.
Okay. Cool.
Probably half on him.
Yeah, so that that totally distracts the cat, and Ruxel's going to be able to very easily get to the hole and kind of push that board out of the way and go in through the little hole in the side of the ball.
I don't even have to roll for it. Yeah. Horace, just for future reference, out of character, of course. You rub the food on their nose. Then they have to like lick it off because it bothers them, right? So you can get them extra distracted. But we'll just... I'll run through the mouse hole. That's fine.
Next time I'll stop and think about that before I try to save you.
Well, you just dump it...
That's a good idea.
You just dump it on the face, right? And then they have to groom it off, and they're distracted by the food smell. You know?
Well, I just dumped it like half on him, so...
Yeah, okay, no, that's great. You did awesome, man. That's all we need. All right. I mean, I'm alive. That's all that matters. I didn't have to use my cat charm.
If y'all don't mind, let's take a quick break here as y'all are getting inside the wall. And we're gonna take just a couple minutes, everyone, and we'll be right back. Appreciate
it. Sounds good.
Woo! Hey,
I'm a leprechaun.
Welcome back, everybody. poor Babs is like, oh, I stepped away and missed it. Yep. Yeah, so y'all have gotten inside. So just a reminder for everybody, I think we got another boost lined up, but you can use channel points. There's a button right underneath the chat box to use channel points to do either a boost die, blue, or a setback die that will either help or harm the players as we go. And so we do
just like this. Just like this, right?
Just like that.
Oh no.
Yeah.
Oh no. Oh, what have I?
Yeah.
Oh.
That's a good thing that doesn't. Expensive. It's a good thing it doesn't count. Expensive.
Yeah, it doesn't count. Goodness. And so, yeah, you have encountered. I do want to be famous by followers.
I'll take
and
care of it.
Do you have a mod? Oh, nice. Okay.
Yeah, and I love what Davian does when you ban somebody. Because this whole big attack thing, it's so fun. But I kind of did want to be famous and buy followers, because that won't get me kicked off of Twitch at all, you know. So
we should set up a sound effect for that every time. Do you want to be famous? Give me ideas now.
Yeah, no kidding, right?
I thought about doing a bikini woodworking stream, but I'm not sure if people would tune in.
Can you do a woodworking hot tub stream?
Yeah, I was just going to suggest hot tub.
Just carving stuff out in the, you know.
The heat and the humidity, it would distort the wood, unless he was dealing with, you know, real, like, hardwoods. You know, it wouldn't make any sense. It's just not.
Hey, tea could probably work.
Teak wood, it would.
It's just, you know. Talking about hardwood with a bikini stream. I'm just, you know.
Oh, Rave, I just had an awesome idea. But let's play. It has nothing to do with hot tubs and everything to do with the modification I want to do to some grotto headsets. Anyway, it doesn't matter. Let's play. I'll find you on Discord later, my man.
Sounds good.
All right, so you have gone through this hole, and you are now inside the wall. There does seem to be kind of a more well used path heading in one direction, rather than the other. You would imagine that that's the path that this creature probably used, but. Before we do that, y'all go ahead and I can't remember which one of you tried to figure out what it was earlier. Was it Ruxel that tried to roll the scene?
No, that was Fator.
Okay, so the other two of you can
I tried to catch it.
Knowledge check against three purple to see if you know what it is.
This should be good.
And where's my knowledge?
It's the a last, top level. It's the right column. It's the last skill.
Against how many purple?
Three.
With one three success purple. And we have... three threat, I think I know exactly what it is, and I have no idea what it does.
Do we have any? Do I have any boost, or do I just do it anyway?
You can use a boost for it, but a horse already succeeded.
Whatever.
So.
I'm just rolling. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. I just get an advantage. You know,
all right. So, you know, these things are called tiny mages, and they are just these kind of small humanoid creatures. They don't seem to have it, you know, despite the fact that they wear shirts and stuff, they don't seem to have any sort of like society or, you know, civilization going. They're just kind of these mean little wizards that sometimes pop up, you know, completely outside of game. This is a creature that I think is only in Final Fantasy IV, and they're just these like hugely tiny, you know, 4 pixel wide creatures that just spam magic spells against you.
Is it bad to Google this right now? Because I'm really curious. I don't have any memory of them.
What is it called?
Tiny Mage.
Tiny Mage.
Tiny Mage. Yeah. That's what it's called. Tiny Mage. Yeah.
Okay. I can show you the hunt. Oh, they're jerks. I can show you the hunt
so
screen.
Cute.
To show you what it looks like.
So cute.
Oh, they're adorable.
Aw. Oh yeah, they're gonna eat our lunch too.
For now.
There it is.
My murder.
That's a flat out leprechaun. That's what that is.
The tiny mage.
Yeah, they're punks.
With strong magic. Okay.
So am I the only one in the wall right now?
No, everybody's there now. Yeah. Yeah.
All right.
Okay, so there's the
We don't
last plaster. That's probably appropriate, right? All right. We don't need no tiny mage. Okay, so there's a well-worn path, and there is a path less traveled by. Well, as a monk, I know the lessons of Robert Frost. Can I roll for perception on which way to go?
Yeah, absolutely.
Is this overthinking it? My perception roll is terrible, even though it should be great.
Yeah, possibly the other way. There are some like boards and stuff that are kind of in the way, and you even without rolling perception, you don't think you went that way. You think there's a way that would require a lot of climbing that he probably would not have wanted to do. I am not trying to trick y'all here.
Fair. Let's go.
I'm more familiar with the lines from Seinfeld where he says, sometimes the road less traveled is less traveled for a reason.
Yeah, for sure. Okay.
All right, everybody. This is a wrap.
Oh. We're going to be dealing with this for the next 45 minutes, aren't
yes.
we? Let's go. Let's go. With those claws, my Wolverine claws, I gesture down the road more often traveled by. Forget you, Robert Frost. Let's do it.
And for our dragoon, you don't have 30 feet above you.
But you have 30 inches.
But you have 30 inches, and that's more than enough.
Yeah. I love it.
Heck yeah.
You know what? We should hook you up with one of these mallets more often. Just imagine if we gave
yes.
you the...
Yes.
Oh, that's a
okay,
great
no,
idea.
No. You jump up 30 inches, and then on the way down, you mallet yourself.
Boom. And I still have the momentum and everything.
I can just throw him.
Could you imagine?
Oh, yeah.
And I'm seeing our viewer numbers just drop. You have chased everyone off.
30 inches.
I mean, really? Because this is phenomenal content, if I'm being honest. I feel good about what's
certainly
happening right
down.
Now. Okay, let's go. We're going.
All right,
doing it.
So y'all are weaving your way through the walls, and it feels like you've been on the road for miles. It's probably been like one room, but mm-hmm. Heading through, and it's like there's like tons of dust in here and wiring and stuff, but. You're definitely seeing a path that this tiny mage would normally take, and as you're weaving through, you're starting to catch a glimpse of him ahead as he kind of like vaults over one of the cross beams and starts heading farther down. And so he's a little bit out of range at this point, but as you keep going, you do seem to be gaining on him until you reach like what would be a fork in the road. As you recognize, you've reached the wall mm-hmm. where the kitchen leads, and so there's a path going each way. You turn, it keeps going in one direction, but there's a way to the side. You turn to that side and you see that he's like trying to scurry up the side of some boards and stuff, and he kind of turns and sees you wide-eyed, and So y'all are within somewhat of a striking distance.
Vautour.
Yes.
I'm a monk. I like justice, man. We get our bounty. We get this guy out of here. I don't know why he's here. Maybe he'd just move on. You want to talk him down?
Try to. All right.
Because I can't. I have a giant reptilian face and big floppy ears and a forked tongue. Ain't nobody going to listen to me with charm of two.
We can try. All right. My character.
Let's ask him to move on.
Looks over and he goes,
wait, listen. We just want to know why you're here. If you can find a way to leave, I don't think you'll have any problems.
Oh, this is so good. Oh man, this is content. Oh.
All right, is anybody else doing anything? I'm just gonna wait for his response.
I mean, I want to look non-threatening.
Hey, but to our hits, it's Navi levels. Hey, listen.
That was my inspiration.
Wow, that's actually my favorite moment in this entire series. I'm just going to say that. Thanks, Thrush Putin. You did it for me. But anyway, yeah, I'm a stand down.
Okay, all right.
Claws retracted.
All right, you see.
It's against my better judgment, but I've been with you guys a while now.
All right, You see him, and he lifts up his hands, and it begins to glow with this fire, but he's kind of holding it there, and he's kind of holding it towards you, and as he's doing that, you hear this loud like scuttering beside you, and you look the other way, and van-sized rat is heading right for you.
Oh man, can we team up with the tiny mage? This would be so dope. Oh,
we are keeping I'm just gonna keep the order that we've been doing, and y'all are basically gonna be clumped, still clumped together, and so
we're clumped. But he can attack us. Who has charm? What's going on? We need to convince him to fight with us, not against us.
Okay. Y'all are all able to go.
Am I muted?
No.
No. Okay. That just didn't work. That's all that. Okay.
I was just trying to explain. Y'all all have a turn to try to charm anybody you want or whatever you want to do before this
actions
rat reaches
speak louder
you.
Than words. This tiny mage is scared, and when he sees us turn our attention from the mage to the rat, bro is gonna fight with us. He's not gonna trust us quite yet afterwards, but we can fight this rat.
Or he's gonna fight this rat.
I mean, maybe, but that's fine.
I do have a yellow and a green in charm. Is that good?
That's not bad. Unless do we split? Does somebody stay and talk him down while two of us fight the rat?
Well, I would like to hit the rat because that's what I do.
Yeah, I mean,
me hit things.
Clearly, me probably too. I mean. Yeah. Let's get the rat. Figure it out later. Yeah.
All right.
Let's do it. Do we have three moves? Any order? Yep.
Any order.
Vautour.
I'm going to. You know what I'm going to do?
I'm going to look at
you. I've been waiting all game to do this.
Oh, you really want to jump, but we might need you to charm, bro. We might need you to charm.
Or do you want me to charm? I can charm.
Why
would you take that for Vautour? Just
jump.
He waits all month for this moment.
Yeah, we're a bunch of smooth-brained meatheads. Let's just
We rely on Jen to take care of all the talky talk.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes.
And the steely
follow your heart, and by that I mean your spear. And all right. You jump, bro. You jump.
So as soon as I hear the scuffling, I said, yes.
For my love. Jump Haley. In.
Here we go.
Oh wait, okay, different.
I turn into a different song.
Yeah. It did. They're both good. They're both excellent.
They're both from the same ish period.
Okay,
1984, right? Yeah.
Have y'all seen
Rad? Yeah, like relatively same era. Van Halen versus the Pointer Sisters.
Yes.
Have y'all seen Rat Race?
Oh.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, I have.
There's a part where Rowan Atkinson is riding with Newman from Seinfeld, and they're playing the radio, and he is singing the complete wrong song, and finally, like, Newman stops the radio and he just stops singing as well, like he thought he was singing along with this song. That apparently is Vautour. Like y'all are all singing one song and he's singing completely other one. Has no idea.
All right, so
what are you drinking out of? What is that?
Stormtrooper.
A stormtrooper like Pilsner glass? Oh my goodness.
A little crazy.
Stormtrooper Pilsner class. He's got a whole set of them.
That's
or
right.
A different.
No, that's not a Pilsner. It's just a normal snifter, right? But I mean, that's all I got. All right, I need Avatar: The Last Airbender. One
that's
of these.
Right.
Thanks for stopping by. I appreciate it.
Yeah. All right, back to the hunt. Let's kill.
Back to
let's
the
kill
hunt.
A thing.
Let's do it.
Kill that.
So
rat.
So this is what. You know, I'm talking to the little mage, and as soon as I hear the scuffle, I turn around and put my spear up. I know it's bad news. And I'm going to jump up in the air.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, dude.
That's great. Good. All right.
Yeah.
You're like, jump. You're like,
oh,
gosh. Like, I have the mental image of this. Like I wish like there was like a normal sized human like watching this. Like it's in a doll's house, and you're like, yeah. So great, so good. All right, you are up in the air, and so when you come back down, you will strike, and you are striking the rat. As that is right.
Yes,
perfect.
Mm-hmm.
Front page of Twitch incoming. Yes, we're just gonna do the tiny adventures of the Hunt Club.
With. With the soundboard. Critical.
We will remake this RPG.
If we make front page of Twitch, yes. I will buy each of you a soundboard so that we can all do the voice.
That's fair. That's super fair, man. Super fair. Yeah.
All right. So what next? Who's up? What are we doing?
All right. I'm gonna charge up and smack the rat with my hammer.
Just all give right. me an advantage, dude. Give me an advantage.
There is a boost in the queue, and so it's going to be two purples.
Wait, and talk to me about the fire materia. Would that give me an additional advantage?
It would.
Against
the rat, yes. It would be beautiful. Another boost.
All right, yeah. Against two purple, you said.
Two purple.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, I'm feeling it.
Oh, dang. Okay. Oh.
That would be five success and an advantage.
I have a plan for this advantage.
Yeah.
Yes.
All right.
You know what I want to happen? The just shockwave from your blow reverberates through the framing and the old lath and plaster, and there's a collapse just on the other side of the tiny mage, so he can't escape from us. He has to talk to us.
Nice, I like
it.
Yeah. I like the way you think.
Okay.
I don't like how the DM is looking at us right now, though.
I like that. That's cool with me. So yeah, it comes crashing down to where he was going. It's like, you know, he had his hand on the ledge as he was pulling himself up, and it's all come cluttering down. And so he drops off, and he, you know, like covers his head. And so yeah, he is he's kind of cornered over there.
Oh yeah. Oh.
All right. And so
what happened to that rat?
It got hit.
Okay, but it's a big rat. That's all we know. It got hit.
It got hit pretty nicely. You know, it was a big hit, but we're having to stylize the attacks a little bit here because you are using like a half inch long hammer. You know, it hit him good. It smacked him
consider
nice. I don't know.
With me now. I un-midge mallet myself right now inside the walls. I become a colossus of destruction. I stomp that rat into oblivion. Oh, wow. So much that Vader Kid just disappeared.
Yeah.
It's like you flatlined.
My bad.
Oh, man. Oh, I'm so close to this, actually. DM, how ready are you for a good time, man?
If you want to do it, let's do it.
Oh, you know what? I kind of just want to kill this rat, too. Like, I want to get it in the eyeballs, is what I, with my claws. I have fire materia, too, right?
I think so, yeah.
Just don't kill the rat, because if Vator comes down and has no target, he's going to sulk for the rest of the night.
Yes, okay. I will.
I mean, chat doesn't have anything to say except for ha 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 ha, which I appreciate, Fresh Putin, by the way. But
Vader Kid ran all of our viewers off with his voice. I'm down with that, but
no, I don't. You know what? It doesn't feel in the spirit of the thing to me. So even though, man, it's a dope idea, because I want to be like, I want to be the Thanatos of this moment. But, you know, I'm just going to strike the rat. That's what I'm going to do. I've got my brawl queued up against two purple.
Two purple. You do have a boost in queue, and you have the fire materia, so that'll be another boost.
Okay, I'll take.
Oh, ripping that
I'll take that nonsense I just rolled.
Killer.
Yeah, seriously. That's almost as good as just Megazording out of the walls. All five Mighty Morphin Power Rangers wrapped up in one reptilian body, which is also a humble monk.
Force Rex.
You know? Yeah, seriously.
All right. Okay. So, the rat
is dead. No.
No.
Horst, you and I rolled identically. Do you see that?
Yeah, you really did. Oh, you had. I'm sorry. You have an advantage. Did you have anything in mind you wanted to do for that?
Oh. Okay. Well, Leprechaun is already trapped. I kind of want to crit it. I just feel like we're just wailing away right now, but I feel like this tiny mage is a bigger problem than we are, than the rat is. Perhaps...
A little Freudian slip there. This tiny mage is a bigger problem than us.
Than we are. Perhaps the tiny mage has a turning deep in his soul. Perhaps Vautour reminds him of a childhood best friend.
I will give you an advantage when that roll comes up.
Okay.
All
Okay. The rat comes down to bite. Mm-hmm. And it is going to bite at Ruxel with... Was that a biting sound?
It's the best he can do. Yeah.
And it you know, its powerful jaws just kind of sink in and do 6 damage.
Oh, nonsense. This rat is a monster. I've got scales. GM, are you aware of that? I have scales.
This thing is
the protective size. Scales.
This thing is the size of a van compared to y'all.
I'm about ready to Moogle myself big again. I'm just saying. Sorry, when I say like midge mallet, I'm totally like, I'm still in the Square Enix count, wrong game, right? I'm in Secret of Mana, I think.
Oh, I think that is where you got that. Yeah. It's what is it called? A luck mallet. Which makes zero sense, but you know, it's Final Fantasy. What are you going to do?
Well, it's lucky if you have one when they use it on you.
Well, it's lucky if you're already small and you can get huge, not the other way around. Otherwise, it's a bad luck mallet, I think.
And so, all right. So the tiny mage kind of, you know, lifts up his hands. It's turning toward the wall, and you see him like pause, and he looks back at y'all. He looks at the rat, and then he turns back to the wall and casts Quake in that direction, and it kind of just rips a hole into the wall where he is, and you see him
Needed a moment.
You see him start to go, but then he stops, and you see him turn around again, and it is y'all's turn.
In this moment, I'm not wasting an initiative on this. But my reptilian eyes are as big as they can be. Those little slit pupils are looking right into his. I am pumping
Your eyes are so big that people can actually see them.
Exactly. All of the emotional, interpersonal meaning I can convey in this moment is tractor beaming into his soul right now. I'm a monk. This is meaningful.
You have like that anime scene where you see the light reflecting in your pupil and there's kind of shaking and tears welling up. Yes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. All right. No, this is over 9,000 what I just did.
9,000?
What are y'all doing this round?
I took five last round. DM, I took five? Six. I took six.
Six.
Can you... Is it cheating to be like, is six big or small? Am I in mortal peril, or was that an unlucky round?
He seemed to have caught a good hold on you that might have been a fortunate strike.
Okay. Continue, Vator.
All right, Vator, you're falling.
I'm coming down for the hit.
All right, so two purple, but you're going to roll all your dice. You're going to double all your dice.
Double all my dice.
And I do think we have one more boost left.
Yes.
So put a blue on there.
Doing it.
And what is your base damage?
It is 5.
Okay, great. Oh yeah, you got him pretty good. It is hurting. It felt that as you kind of came down to his back and stabbed him. You do have an advantage. Any idea you want for your advantage?
Did the little mage decide to run?
He has not run. He is still there.
He's turned back.
So when I stab my, you know, spear into this, you know, into the back of this this rat, I look up. Do I have the ability to shout out to him one last time? Because I was having a conversation. I jumped up and then I hit the rat.
Yeah.
So I'm aware of, you know, the goal at hand. This rat's just a distraction. So I yell to the little mage.
Wait, we don't want to hurt you. We just want to talk.
I love you, bro.
All right. Yeah. I dig it. We just got to pump out the vibes, whatever they are.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay. So who's next?
Horse has no vibes.
Horse is the only one not trying to, like, no, come on to our side. Horse, like, I don't care. Whap.
Chwag. Do I get to kill it?
Hammer rat.
Hammer rat.
Wail away, man. Just do it.
That's
up
my
the
favorite.
Jam.
Are we sitting on another boost?
No, that was the last boost.
Okay.
Osorojo is trying to give you boost, but that is against the rules.
And I will hit the rat.
Smack.
Wow,
yeah.
That was pretty sad.
That was not great, but you got an advantage on there. So, any ideas on an advantage?
Oh, I'm terrible with advantages. Let's see. No, I got nothing still. Rojo, you're my advantage guy. What do you got?
Oh, man. Sorry, I'm worried about MC Hammer lyrics right now. Because that's my favorite moment in the entire MC Hammer canon right there.
Does little MC Hammer come out of the wall?
Yeah. I've toured around the world from London to the Bay. It's Hammer, go Hammer, MC Hammer, yo Hammer, and the Wrist King, go man, look, can't touch this. Yeah, anyway. I'm sorry.
On that note,
that's somebody cold. Else has got to go. Somebody else has got to go. I don't have anything right now. Hold on. Just give me a moment. Ruxel's going to go into the corner and meditate. He's going to talk to the universe and think about an advantage.
Don't give up on it. You are too legit to quit.
I hit that thing so good that the mage realizes he doesn't want to mess with us.
No, that's quality. Anything we can do to bring the mage back to our side.
Jim's friend says, well, he's clearly listened to that song more than once. What's really sad is for years I had the entire Can't Watch This by Weird Al Yankovic memorized. And could you hear the whole song of that?
Can't watch this.
Oh, you just Googled the lyrics.
You just Googled the lyrics.
Oh, White Nerdy was a great one.
Yeah.
Rolling. My 20-sided.
Yeah, so I like the idea of this mage, like, just seeing our prowess. He's seen our kindness. He's seen our magnanimity, our justice.
Magnanimity.
He's getting a really good sense.
Magnanimity.
Magnanimity.
He's getting a really good sense of your character. I like it.
Really, yeah. I mean, he's we're not after him. We're after the bounty. There's a difference.
Yeah. All right, so... Ruxel.
This tiny mage has a tiny realization.
We're after the booty.
Hasten to the booty.
Now he's seen your booty. He's seen your magnanimity.
No. Hasten to the booty is an old-timey translation of an old Bible verse, which I really appreciate. So what are we doing here? I've got that. I took 6 or 7 in the last round.
Hmm. Look, the only reason we're trying to hurt you is because of money. We're not bad guys.
We're just trying to make a living, dude. Hey, little mage. We just want you to leave.
But for real, what? Where's my health at?
It's wounds on your character sheet.
You're at 9 out of 13.
Oh, really? That's it on my character sheet?
On your character sheet.
Hold on.
Now, did you take any earlier?
I don't even know what's going on anymore. No. Oh no, I adjusted myself to 6 out of 13 when you gave me that thing. So it was 7. That's right.
Yeah, okay.
I just adjusted it live on Genesys, I guess.
Yeah.
Okay.
Gotcha. Okay.
Oh. I want to be a hero. You know what? All right. I'm like, my thigh is like flayed open. My femoral artery is like squirting blood all over the place. Huh.
Where Seriously. Have all the heroes gone?
You can see the thanks. Yeah. Oh man, I'm thinking of Dawson's Creek right now, and I shouldn't be. And that's where all the cowboys gone. But it doesn't matter. First,
you leave Pacey alone.
Yeah. Seriously, I look the leprechaun right in the eye, right dead in the eye. As I'm squirting blood onto the floor like an ICU code blue or red or whatever it is, right? He knows this is a moment, right? And I give him the vibe. I pump a vibe. We're your friends. And then I look at that rat and I pump all the brawl I have into that thing's just decrepit, stinking corp. Do I need to spend some channel points on a boost? Because I will. Oh, I can flip a light side point. It doesn't matter. I'm gonna finish this thing. Do y'all approve? All right, here we go. I flipped a light side point. Oh wait, did I hit plus or do I just flip the thing? Okay, I just flipped the thing. Right. Okay.
But you flipped the dark side. I'll fix it. Go ahead. Good try. I tried that earlier.
So I was hoping you were gonna pull
that
off.
Okay. 2, 2, 2. Is that right? That's all right. Do I have any other? Do I have a boost? Do I have a boost too?
Not right now.
Okay.
Well, you do for your fire materia.
Okay, yeah. I want to Kamehameha everything I've got and all of the emotional energy that I've cultivated with this leprechaun into this rat's fetid existence. Yes. Oh, look at that triumph.
The triumph.
I want brains on my claws. Can you give me brains on my claws? That's what I want right now. Oh, what is that? What is that?
You're charging up your Kamehameha.
Okay. Sorry. Okay. You can't roll better. You can't roll better. Well, you can technically, but not really, right?
Okay. You open this thing's skull, and it's just it's. There is blood and goop and stuff everywhere, and it's like in its dying throes, and kind of it's like still, it's like momentum is still pulling it forward. And as you kind of glance back at the tiny mage, you see him just lift up a hand and cast Thundara. And a bolt of lightning comes off of his hand and shoots past you and just. It just hits the rat and pushes it back into the wall as it twitches from, loss of brains and being electrocuted. And the rat has died, and the tiny mage kind of looks at you, and he looks nervously back at the hole in the wall that he made with his quake spell.
Mm. All right. Vator does not do this a lot.
This is your time. This is your chance. Every moment, leave nothing to chance.
Vator holds his hand up, and he takes a spear and he lays it down in front of him.
And he holds his hand out. Like Chris Pratt in Jurassic Park.
If you had been able to keep that rat at bay like that, that would have been impressive. All right. The tiny mage will consider you. And then he will. You see him kind of sigh, and then he comes up to you, and he's got like this little pocket, and he pulls something out of it, and he holds it in front of you, and you see like this tiny, tiny piece of ham. It's a little frozen.
Oh, he just wanted ham. This is what I want to recommend. I'm gonna hold out my hand. Will he hop into it?
You're into the same hand? Size as him. Yeah, you're about the same size right now.
Oh, crap! You're right. No, I'm just gonna say to him then. I know a better place you can go. And I look at Horst and I look at Vator and I wink and they both know. I mean, it's the Hunters Club. We'll make Montblanc deal with this nonsense.
Yeah.
You are going to have like your own mascot now. That's amazing.
I must have, you know, a piece of meat I was still eating.
Yeah.
Probably I got some scraps left on my leg that I carried with me. So
do I have any soldiers?
I'll take the ham from him
soldiers rations
and hand him my leg of meat.
Nice, yeah. All right.
Do I have any like soldiers rations or anything on me?
Sure. Yeah. Yeah. Y'all gonna have a meal together in there, inside the wall? This would be amazing.
I'll pull out an MRE.
Oh yeah. I'm vibing right now.
Like I'm imagining that you're like fast forwarding a little bit. Y'all are now all full sized again, and you have a tiny mage in your pocket. And you're holding up a dead rat to Jonathan and says, "Well, it turns out it was a rat after all." And
it's so good. It's so good.
You know what I was thinking.
Miss Pennywhistle.
I didn't stab him. I'm sorry.
Jonathan seems quite annoyed with all the mess that you made, but Miss Pennywhistle is very pleased and she's just, "Jonathan, just bring it the workers, they'll fix that right up. Don't even worry about it. You young men, I thank you so much for your help, and of course here's your gill, and I very much appreciate it. Hopefully I will not need your services again."
If you do, you know where to find us.
If I may, I walk up to Fluffy Butt, who's sitting on her lap, no doubt.
Mm-hmm.
Give him a pat on the head. I pull a salamander out of my pocket and feed it to him.
Nice. Yeah, and you had noticed that Mr. Fluffy Bum had been like looking at your pocket. Like with narrow eyes the whole time, but definitely takes that and is very, very pleased. And so you have earned 2,700 gil and 10 experience. And
what? Does that even matter? Have we used any of that?
Well, no, you haven't. But now that I'm filling out we're filling out the actual rules, we can, but we need to do something very, very special because this hunt is now vanquished. Y'all can't, the chat can hear the victory fanfare. Y'all can't hear it.
Oh, bummer. Oh, vanquished, tiny mage.
I don't think that's the right fanfare.
Yeah, that's. Man, you know,
he wasn't The mage wasn't vanquished, though. He was just, it was catch and release.
For the purposes of the hunt, you have succeeded.
I like it.
Yeah, I didn't know how that was going to go. If y'all were going to end up just charging in and killing it, or figuring out a way to let it live. I'm happy it went the way it did. That was fun.
I feel like
Fear
really
too. Are you kidding me?
Little mage.
What's that?
So I feel like we're really connected with this little mage, and he can just stay with us in our pocket, and we can release him to fight whatever we're
going to fight. I haven't even thought about that. Yeah, he's like a spirit animal, man. Yeah. Oh, man.
He's a summon.
Oh,
that's
crap.
Goodness, that's not bad. That's a...
How are you going to deal with that, DM? How are you going to deal with that?
That's a pretty good idea, I think that needs to have. I think that needs to be a thing.
A little mage in her pocket.
And you're,
as long as he just wants food, right?
You're the talker, Vator. Horse does the feeding. You do the talking. I do the meditating, I guess. I don't know how it works out.
Somebody's got to clean up the litter box.
You're really gonna like Margarita when she comes back.
I think her name is Mezcal, isn't that? We've forgotten.
I do appreciate everybody tuning in. Now, tomorrow, Maps for Marsha's channel, we are doing our open mic night. Vader Kid and I are both performing there. It's going to be a fantastic time, and so I do hope that if you are not following Maps, please do so, and that way you'll get notification. But it is tomorrow, I think, at 8 Central Time, and so that's going to be a ton of fun. I'm pretty sure I'm going to be playing mostly originals, but I think that I'm going to try to, since I play a video game song every time, I think I'm going to tackle Eyes on Me this time.
And, oh, wow.
And so that'd be fun. Otherwise, really appreciate y'all hanging out. This game is, being turned into a podcast, and, Sorojo, thank you for the gift sub.
It's Dude, cheaper than a beer and a lot more fun.
I will. That's awesome. I appreciate it. And so what? This week I am starting Octopath Traveler on Thursday. Ooh. Here. I'm looking forward to that. And so y'all want to do introductions to farewell, introduce yourself again, and then we will depart for the evening.
This game looks amazing.
After you.
What game is it?
Octopath Traveler? What on earth?
Yes.
Oh, have you not seen it? It's gorgeous.
It's good.
I don't keep up with stuff anymore.
Yeah, but I don't like new games, but Octopath, it's gorgeous.
I can't buy a Switch for this, but I kind of wanna.
It's almost.
Or I can just watch you.
I have it on computer. I have it on PC.
Oh, so, okay.
Yeah, we're gonna start that and be playing through that for a long time because it's a big game. Mm-hmm. There's apparently octopaths.
They have no idea who each other are, and they meet each other. That's my one complaint. But
all right,
it's good. Y'all say
it's still good.
Y'all say bye. Tell people who you are. I'm Paul. People are other people. Go.
I'm Ravenant.
I'm Oso Rojo. I don't matter. Subscribe to Vader Kid and Paul. Catch you later. Oh, and Techno Funk Boy. I mean, woo!
I'm Vader Kid 08. Thank you for having me. I stream on normally Mondays, Tuesdays, and Thursdays. This week I'll be streaming Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday. But catch me out on twitch.tv/VaderKid08, and I'll see you around. Thanks for having me.
Yeah. No one I know, at least no one relatively small, is streaming right now. Vader Kid, do you know anybody who's on?
Drowsy Ghost TV, first time playing guitar.
Do you know this person?
Pretty, just... I do. I've been in his channel a couple times. Pretty cool dude.
Okay.
He's got a really cool raid. He's got a really cool raid video.
Oh, all right. All right. Let's raid. Let's raid that then. And, great. I appreciate it. And we will see y'all next time.